record label still slipping on us. I feel like white people still spitting on us, cause we can't drink the water still. So why we gotta pay the water bill if the government done quit it on us? Look, I love Obama, but it's fuck Obama. Fuck the whole United States, see I ain't trust Obama. He claimed to Flint to be a puppet, man I witnessed it. He lied and said the water was safe, but barely sipped the shit. I swear to God, man I cried after that. And when you left, you know how many kids died after that? Stupid, I wonder if you still had your pride after that. Cause I burned every poster you ever had right after that. And look, motherfuckers wanna tell me that my vote count. If the person that we picked ain't in control, then it don't count. We need
Flint out the dark.
Years, we just picking who we want to oppress us. So let me stop with the lecture, cause I guess I'm being extra. Cause I'm quick to raise the stock up like I'm an investor. These niggas say I'm being ignorant. No, I'm giving effort.
Live from your place, family room, 6715 North Saginaw Street, in the heart of the North Side.
Ski mask with the Glock, we wear two for a fashion, with one strapped over the shoulder like they do in the pageant. Hey, it's the school of hard knocks, I had too many classes, court dates and funerals, we got used to the habits. So when Gucci made that stupid ass sweater, already seen more black faces on shirts than you can imagine. Either the shirt said free me or RIP me. These rap lyrics is watered down, this shit getting cheesy. Is it Kiki, is it Fifi, or was it ZZ? Is it Frankie, is it Stoney, or was it TT? Either way, I gotta set it off like Cleo did and set it off. For them days I had stress on my chest and I couldn't let it off. With my toy spray, Floyd May, this bitch ain't never lost. I put my life on the line and that's a line you should never cross. I'm from where they never make it, shit didn't...
Yo, this is Flint out the dark. H-O-G-G.
What it do?
Man, we blessed, baby.
Honored to be here, baby.
Yes, sir. Hood Lord Stoney C, what it do, baby?
That's right. You know I'm saying all praise due to Allah. We back up in this joint.
Yeah. Flint at the dark. Man, H-O-G-G, who the fuck is the MSF? The MSF. The motherfuckers, Michigan Strategy Fund. They supposed to give... They gave the people $5.5 million to the capital. MSP gave $3 million to create jobs, $14.2 million to create another 562 jobs. Where the fuck is these people at? Because I don't know none of these people got these jobs. What the hell they living at, bro?
No, fam, I didn't even know that was up.
Yeah, man.
In terms of it affecting the normal people who are supposed to do what it's meant for.
Go ahead, cuz.
So at the end of the day, knowledge is power, and we've been powerless to even know I don't even know nobody that's even received those benefits.
Exactly, bro. Where is these people living at? That's what I want to know. That's a lot of money, man. $46 million during a water crisis, bro? What the fuck is the Ferris wheel, man? I don't know nothing about none of that shit. You know what I'm saying? It's benefiting, you know what I'm saying? It's benefiting them, man. I got some facts. I got some numbers. Let me see. Okay, they say economic development project in downtown Flint. In 2016, the heart of the water crisis. You remember when the brothers came down?
Right.
When that 2016?
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? That was the heart of the water crisis, bro. They spent $46 million, man. On that shit, man. You know what I'm saying? Let me see. They say the ex-city officials at that time and ex-state officials, they need to be held accountable because they was allowing this development plan to be taking place. But my opinion is, I think they was getting kickbacks. You know what I mean? Because you know when you get developers, they kick you back, man. And they was real, real candid to do that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to say no names, but just ex-officials, state and city. You know, you feel me? Big, how you feel about that, man?
I mean, that's consistent with what the politics is, B. That ain't nothing new under the sun. Right. You know what I mean? The reality is that we're living out the repercussions of it. You know what I mean? So, at the end of the day, like, again, I don't know. I can't speak of anyone that I know of who was affected the most that even knew those resources was available to them. So, of course, we already know the long history of Flint's politics is they take care of the top and everything, and nothing trickles down to the bottom. So that's consistent with their program, homie.
I need you to chime in on that, Stony C. You being a business owner, entrepreneur of Flint, Michigan, Northside, I need you to chime in on that.
First of all, you know, as it don't really, you know, take that much, you know what I'm saying, for nobody to see that we suffering on this end. Deep down on the north, somehow, you know what I'm saying, some funds ain't making it all the way down to the end of the list.
Man, who you talking about, man?
Shit. I'm talking about, man, maybe we don't have the information that's delivered to us up here, too.
Okay.
You know, that could be a breakdown.
That could be
too.
It. That could be it.
But how can we bridge that gap to get the information farther up here, or we get the ones who get the information, not to hold the information?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Because that means a lot, too. If you get the information, you're supposed to pass the information off. How can we have a meeting up here at 6715 North Saginaw Street and get more information about how can we get grants and loans to be better businesses, people, or get the knowledgeable people to help us do the paperwork that we need to do?
Right. To piggyback off that, the black skill trade, the black developers, the black business owners, carpenters, plumbers, et cetera, man, we need to get together before it's too late, man. You know what I'm saying? We more powerful in numbers, man. And that's what basically this shit is with that development program. You fading all the black carpenters and developers. We don't know nothing about that, man. All them men, they out of town getting checks. They on the outskirts. They don't live in the Flint city limits. You know what I mean?
Chime in with your recommendations. But not only recommendations, man, it's time for plan of action. You know what I mean? And my add to the circle is this. What can be done? One, we actually setting the seed now to be able to broadcast the information where it's a topic that you know that's prevalent to you. Another thing, with this raggedy-ass voting shit, voting don't matter, my dude, if you don't know or understand what it is that's on the table that's being bargained between the two so that you know who makes your vote valuable.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? So I'm going to say this. You can't lazily win no war.
Man, you know the name sound good, though.
What's that?
The name. You know, any name sound good, you got to have the right name.
Exactly.
I don't know why people ain't looking at me, then when they get bit, they be like, damn, but the name sounded good.
Because
you ain't do your work.
Laziness not to do your own research.
Yeah, you know, this is my opinion only, you know what I'm saying? I don't, you know what I'm saying? This is what I'm saying. They, as far as that goes, they plan is to fade the north side out. They ain't leaking no grant money, no type of, you know, money this way. They want the property value to go down so they can come in and buy places like your place, family room, but it's not going to happen this way. And then come back in, do their development, and then charge you out the ass for low income. They're supposed to be low income, and they get you out the legit way. And they want the north side back, man. They trying to fade this out, man. Because they dumped $46 million in downtown Flint, man. You know, I only know people that go downtown Flint for connecting bus routes. They go downtown, catch the bus, get back on another bus, go where they going. Man, the people where I'm from, they never been to no damn Ferris wheel. You ever been to Ferris wheel, cuz?
For what?
The business called the Ferris wheel. One of the businesses that got a lot of money. Well, I don't even know what that shit is.
You
man.
Know what? I'm gonna say this. It's
go to the land bank and get turned down for property, and that's it on the north side.
Right.
That's all I can say.
And they own 95% of the low income or the properties in the city's period. See. Again, it's a must at this stage, man, we get heavy on our game. And it ain't just complaining about what we hearing. It's actually getting strategic about what you going to do with it. For another example is, just like brother just talked about, vocational trades. Listen, everybody got some skill that you do. Pimp your own self. It's time to pimp your own self out. Real talk. Because you don't let your enemies pimp you longer enough. And that's the bottom line of what we really talking about. Unless you economically empower, man, somebody else can cut off the way that you feed yours. We already know where we at. So we ain't going to spend a whole bunch of time complaining about the same thing that we know everybody knows. The issue we talk about is being problem solvers. The issue at this stage is to be your own entrepreneur at something, even if you at work. We got people who go to work 12 hours a motherfucking day and still have to venture out into whatever it is that you're going to leave your daughters and children. Because where you work every day is, you know, we all got to report to a slave master at some point. But at the end of the day, make sure you pimping you too.
What you doing with that dollar?
Yeah. That dollar got a bill. That dollar ain't the spin. That dollar is the bill. The dollar is the seed. You put the seed in the ground, and then you get a harvest.
Yeah, my whole point with this topic about this $46 million, because they closed the water pies, man. That's going to be money to keep the water pies open. Excuse me. I mean, we shouldn't have to go to Kroger's and Walmart and buy water. I mean, we should, but we shouldn't have to. We have no choice, man. Then they be giving out contaminated water, old all-day water, man. Man, these people around here, man, they really showing they don't care about black people. And they sacrifice a few of their own just to get rid of us. Because we know it's some poor white people here, too, just as well as it's poor black people. But it's more poor black people. You know what I'm saying? And they sacrifice their own to get rid of us. It's crazy, man. This shit crazy.
Cuz, I'm going to say this, B, I agree, but let's go further. Let's go to a whole global standpoint.
Okay.
Anybody, all of us are expendable. We did 95%. We don't matter in the first place. We never did. You know what I mean? We ain't in the Constitution, homie, none of that. So at the end of the day, this is the time that real talk, we use this mantra between us, we all we need.
Right.
Well, that ain't like something just slick to say.
Right.
It's a mindset. Every last one of us be getting up doing something that makes your everyday struggle work for the ones around you. It's time to kill your selfishness. It's time to kill individuality, thinking that what you're doing for your stop allowing your opinion to be your God, and involve yourself in the struggle of your people. Because at the end of the day, your struggle by yourself, it keeps you isolated, which is the whole plan of the enemy. Flat out.
I agree with you. I agree with you, bro. And you know, man, I totally agree with you, man. But I just can't get over the fact that we still don't have clean water, 5 years later? You know what I'm saying? And it's just ridiculous. I'm just not finding out about the $46 million, even though it's old. But what's old to them is new to me. And it's ridiculous, man. But we gonna keep the north side pumping, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, you got all the elements sagging on both sides, man. Black on. The hood got to save the hood. Thank you, hood lord. The hood got to save the hood. Matter of fact, coming soon, we're going to have the hood got to save the hood t-shirts. You'll be able to get them right up here. It's 6715 North Saginaw Street. Your place, family room. You know what I'm saying? The hood got to save the hood, man.
Hey, yo, man. Mad shout out to my nigga Ross, man. Buy the hood, homie.
Buy it up. Buy it up.
For all y'all get money cash, man. You know what I'm saying? Who don't know what to do with your bread. Man, buy your hood up, B. Because you renting somebody else's shit. We all think about it, B. If you don't own where you live, somebody always in a position to tell you to move, my dude. Attack this land bank shit, my dude. Get 5 or 10 of you cats together and buy all the cribs on your block. And all the raggedy motherfucking yards in between. Get all that shit. Clean that shit up, my nigga, so you got a motherfucking private playground for you and your kids. Come on, dude. It's time to just take it. And honestly, real talk, it's really like mad game, because we sitting here saying we mad or watching motherfuckers do it, but the game is already exposed. So take your twos and fuse and run the game the same way. For instance, this the whole highway system being changed on the north side, that shit been playing for over 25 motherfucking years. That ain't no new shit. So no, they not going to feed the peasants, my nigga, that they want to move the fuck out so that they can move in.
The issue is link your pennies and do something with it versus sitting back complaining about what the fuck is being done to you.
New
real
t-shirt,
shit.
New t-shirt. Link Come on, your man. Pennies.
Link your pennies. Pennies, nigga. Pennies make dollars. Real talk. But more than anything, keep your opinion where it really deserves to be, which is not in the conversation at all. Because if you going after something you ain't never had, like the big sis, you know what I'm saying, little sister actually, Erykah Badu say, the wisest man knows that he knows nothing at all. So let's stop being in competition and not listening in conversation with each other so you can actually hear something more than what you know so you can add it to the information you got. Because see, what happens is we get lost in the conversation using this European shit of either or. I got to, you know, either it's my information or your information. No, it's a circle of information. African, get back to your true African mindset, man. All is included. It wouldn't matter one bit if I had $1 trillion and all my other, the rest of my family was broke. We all broke if all of them can't flourish.
So what do you think still, though, after this, when the next round comes or when everybody wake up to the situation, what could we do to revive or benefit to get the information more to us deeper in the north side, you know, minority business?
Thanks, Mike. Great question. Great question. I would answer that like this. Each one teach one and keep applying to the puzzle. A puzzle ain't complete until all the little pieces fit. And there is no little piece to the total picture. Quit treating people like their piece is little when they come to you.
Right.
Treat the janitor as though he the CEO.
That's right.
Flat out. And quit taking your anger out on those that ain't got shit to do with your motherfucking struggle.
Exactly.
Real shit. And I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna try to control my language. I apologize.
You good, baby. Say that's why they call this Flint at the Dark, baby. It's Flint at the Dark. Let me play another song for my boy Zicky, man. We'll be right back. We'll be right back.
Fuck wrong with niggas. Like we want, don't come after niggas, nigga. We ready.
Ready or not, here I come.
Y'all niggas better wake up. Gun hood to the motherfucking world blow. Gang. Nigga, LMF, pussy. Loyalty makes family. Woo! Blood only make you related, nigga. Want it. Yeah. Gang. Yeah. They done got him out of his element. Yeah. It's to the point, so I can't tell him shit. Hey, this is what happens when an African American open up his eyes and then tap into his melanin. It's some pussy niggas in this world. Let's talk. It's the thin line from being a bitch and you cost. You know, I seen them shot you niggas do. Uh-huh. I caught it. Take it up and bear. Jordan to Oprah, ain't none of them gon' ride. If I hit them with this 9, I better open up their mind. And Drake, you a snake, I'll shoot you till you die. And then walk up on the body just because you looked alive. Facts. I ain't ready to die, but I'm planning for this shit. If this mean I'm going to hell, then I'm tanning for this shit. I'm tanning for this shit, motherfucker. I'm ready, yeah. I'm ready. Too crazy on this bitch.
Gotta go.
Watch this. We ready.
Watch this.
The beat's this. Crazy. Hey. What up, Ray? Hey. This bitch crazy. Hey. Look, hey, we got niggas wearing rainbows with their hair dyed. Yeah. Nigga, how is you a blood, but you never mind.
We got True and Mag just walked in the house. One of the goats of Flint, Michigan. 20 plus years of service to your city. We'll be getting with him in a minute.
Okay, I get it now. The game is much different now. They'd rather hear the beat than actually what a nigga spitting out. And Jay-Z still sneak dissing niggas, huh? Talking on our money phones got you tripping, huh? Oh, you been out the hood so long, you can't visit, huh? You must forgot it cost to talk long distance, huh? Facts. You damn right, old nigga, it's a disconnect. You damn right, we took that little shit as disrespect.
Damn right.
Why not use your platform to drop some intellect? Now you gotta pay to call this phone, boy, this
facts. The government got niggas scared to have babies. We been curing cancer, that's why they kill safety. I ain't ready to die, but I'm planning for the shit. If this mean I'm going to hell, then I'm tanning for the shit. Motherfucker, motherfucker.
Here I come, you can't hide. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and make you. Yo. Make you.
Yo.
Yo, 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 we back. Flint out the dark. We back. We had the top. The first topic was about that $46 million economic development program downtown Flint, Michigan. You know what I'm saying? We touched on that. HOGG, Heavy O Gang Global, and Stony C, a.k.a. the Hood Lord. We right here on the north side of Flint, Michigan. 6715 North Saginaw Street. We yes, bringing sir, the north side back, baby. We bringing the north side back.
Yes, sir, buddy.
Yeah. I want to touch on what happened down there at the park at Burston. First, I just want to say we as black people, we're our own worst enemy. I mean, it only takes a few rotten apples to spoil a whole bunch, but we got to do better on the north side of Flint, Michigan. We got to hold our own people accountable for our actions. Real talk. Shout out to all the people that was responsible for bringing that beautiful court to the north side of Flint, Michigan. Kyle Kuzma and the NBA Players Association. And Brian Nolan, a.k.a. BB. Salute.
That's right, that's
salute,
right.
BB. That's salute. Right.
North side.
North side all day long in America, cuz. You know what I'm saying? Salute. You know what I'm saying? The hood got to save the hood. What? You know what I'm saying? We can't sit around and wait on government assistance, city assistance. You know what I'm saying? But on a sad note, and on a positive note, the people responsible have turned themselves in. And they will do no jail time, which is good. I think it's good. But they got to do a lot of community service, pay damages, and a bunch of other stuff. And take a tour of the Flint lockup. You know what I'm saying? And
so guess what? Can I say this
just one? Nobody going to jail. Let me get your take on that, B. What you think, B? What so, you think?
Real talk, I think is poetic justice because we got to look at who we talking about, B. Like this, you know, third, fourth, fifth generation that's affected by this chemical warfare that's been plagued on our people. Let's just call it what I'm gonna talk about it on some global shit, you know, real quick. This is chemical warfare that my people have been going through for like 5-6 different generations. So, and everyone knows what that's the whole reason they tripping about the lead part, because it's undeniable what lead does to the psyche of an individual in terms of their ability to be able to control the pituitary gland and their ability to be able to deal with stress and anger. So it's been historical in big cities all over this country who know about Flint and how Flint get down and all that from just the behaviors of a people who've been chemically poisoned for years intentionally. So I was told by the very wise counsel of one of my elders in my family to curve myself when I first came home. Cause I was on fire. I'm on fire for my people, and I'm not scared. There's no fear. You know what I'm saying? So when you no longer fear, then you move like the Most High desires you to move. But it's seasons for when the Most High designates your storm. I'm real specific about what I'm saying. It's real specific. Your storms are set in time so you to respond. Through the toil of what you go through, the strength that you learn going through that obstacle is the blessing and the talent that's going to be needed to forge through what's coming at us.
Right.
100.
100. Oh, and I just want to say this before I forget. Hell no, them water ain't fixed in Flint, Michigan. I'm telling you, world, I'm in the trenches every day. Every day. North side, south side, west side. The water not fixed. Don't let them tell y'all different. The hell no.
And people still being displaced from their homes for not paying, not keeping up to date payment on the water that is polluted, that cannot be used healthily or with the freedom of not worrying about being contaminated. And you're still expected to pay the exact same fee as though the water was healthy for you.
Man, that shit like, crazy, like, man.
Just for a moment, let it soak in.
That shit crazy. Who was that, cuz? Shelf Neely.
Yeah.
Salute to Shelf Neely. You know salute to Shelf Neely.
Them and his team, they've been doing their thing, you know what I'm saying, over there. I've been watching them and stuff. I really like their movement and everything. It's just that we got to come together on the city council and park and get our areas cleaned up. And that's what we're going to really work hard on as a team between us. We're going to go off in these neighborhoods, man, in the spring, man, and try and drag all the trash out we can.
You hear that? Stony C says he gonna put together a team and they gonna clean up the north side.
You know, so much trash dumped back in these little small neighborhoods down the side, man. That's rubbish. You know what I'm saying? You know, they need big dumpsters over there on the north side to clean up. And I know it's some organizations that will get in contact with us. Where they gonna get in contact with us at?
They gonna get in contact with us. They can either contact us on Facebook. That's Stony Carmichael or Terrence O'Sell or Big Flint Hog. These are all Facebook handles. And the same thing on Instagram, or you can call 810-210-3468 or 701. What's your number, cuz? 701-0784. You know what I'm saying? If you get contact with us anytime, you want to be involved in anything.
He said original cricket on that joint.
Original cricket joints. 701. Salute the cricket. It was cricket. That remind me of the old Westwood days. the old Westwood days. Boy, that 701. I bought them girls up in we ain't gonna talk about that one. We ain't gonna talk about that one. Matter of fact, because remember we was working Westwood too. Yeah. But let's get back to the subject at hand. You know what I'm saying? Like I say, I got Trio Magazine in the house. You know what I'm saying? Support this brother. He's been around 20 plus years. You know what I'm saying? When it was the regular old paperback magazine, you know what I'm saying? Now he's digital. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's 2020, baby. He been around for 20 plus. How long you been around, cuz?
We're
20 years in the game?
Yeah.
20 years in the game, man. That, you know what I'm saying? That's a blessing, man. That's a blessing.
Let me give thanks to all our customers, everybody from Big Chief in the Rush out of Flint, Coop the Real out of Pontiac, Cassius out of here, Ridgeway out of here. You know what I'm saying? Man, Peripheral, Funk Room, right. Alien Planet, you know right. what I'm saying? Right. Shout out to the Lose, the Loft, all the promoters, Dink.
Right.
Everybody, you know what I'm saying? Everybody everywhere. Shout out to Lavish Living for continuing to do what they do. They got the Daughter Dances, which is dope, nice, you know what I mean? Shout out to it's a t-shirt company on Detroit Street, they popping too. There's a lot of black businesses out here now, you know, from when we was out in our early years just on paper. They couldn't afford to promote, but they still, you know, put flyers out and put their heart into it, and a lot of them done been successful in that.
Right.
Congratulations to those that made it 20 years with us, just rolling with this music business that ain't really been here for us, but we made it here for us. So thanks to all of those guys, man.
Yeah, how do they get a hold of you guys?
810-701-0784. That's the MAG number, of course. It's been in business for 20 years. I'm JTV Live myself. You know, I work the camera, so people know who I am, and I make it hard to find me, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
We got you out tonight, man.
Exactly. So you heard that.
Yeah,
salute to Trill Magazine. They've been around 20 years plus. Salute. Salute. Matter of fact, let me give him a 3-gun salute. No, I'm gonna give him a 20-gun salute.
Bam!
20 years. Salute. that's my book. Green Pieces of Paper.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm dropping. Next week I'm dropping a water crisis book called Black Water. The Flint Water Crisis Memoirs, and then I'm dropping another urban joint. Nothing to something to come up. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm staying busy. I got my own sausage seasoning, Fat Boy style barbecue. You know what I'm saying? Got my own sausage seasoning. You know what I'm saying? I'm in the edible game. I got some Medi Ranch right there, some Medi barbecue sauce, some peanut butter and chocolate brownie joints. Lay you all the way down, baby. You know what I'm saying? That's what it is, baby. That's what it is. You know what I'm saying? See, I've been cooking seriously since about 2014.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
What you mean
seriously, I took it seriously. I got me a business name and went and got registered, and I started grinding. I invested in myself because you was right there from the start, right behind me with the camera phone when I'm coming down the street pulling that old rusty-ass grill. You remember that, cuz? You remember that? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it is what it is, cuz. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's been fun. It's been real fun.
It's a lot of good people here. There's a lot of heart in this city.
Yeah, it's a lot of heart here.
You got to be from here.
We just gotta stick together, man. It's just, we got a lot of a separation. You got like the in crowd. You got the brown noses. You know what I mean? I'm just putting it out there, man.
Leaders,
you know what I'm saying?
Man.
Oh, you got some leaders too. Yeah.
Bro,
you know what I'm saying? Right. Right. You looking at a few of them right here.
Oh, yeah.
All in this room. Kings, baby. We kings. You know what I'm saying?
Also, so. The whole movement is that we promote the building of new kings.
Yep.
And those that don't know they're kings already. You know what I'm saying? This is the wake.
Did y'all introduce him? JTV?
Oh, yeah. I got my name in there.
Yeah, he got in there. You got in there. We need to hear from you. We're trying to get you in there, bro. You know what I'm saying? Trill Mag, baby. Trill Magazine. Goats. One of the goats of Flint, Michigan, baby. You know what I'm saying? One of the goats of Flint, Michigan, bro. Shit, man.
It's always the first, especially when we deep in Flint. We know we make it happen.
Yeah. Trill. Yeah. Maybe I can make the cover one day. Maybe I can make the cover. Hint, hint. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Maybe, you know what I'm saying?
When you want to shoot it?
See, whenever, baby. I'm ready.
We live, right?
Hey, baby, I'm three. Listen, bro. I'm 3 books in published. You know what I'm saying? Last year, this time, I didn't have a book out. I'm 3 in. I got 2 soundtracks, all Flint young niggas with fire and desire in their heart. If it ain't Flint, I ain't fucking with it. You know what I'm saying? I'm pro Flint, bro.
That's pro Flint magazine.
You know what I'm saying? Here go my man magazine, Trail Magazine. Y'all know who he is. If y'all from Flint, y'all know who he is. He's been around over 20 years. You know what I'm saying? Man, it is what it is. See, let's get back to this topic at hand. HOGG. Like I said, who the fuck is the MSF? For these giddy motherfuckers, they say $5.5 million to Capitol Theater. Another $3 million to create 100 jobs, another $4.2 million to create 562 jobs. Man, what the fuck is these jobs? What the fuck is these people, man? These facts, man. These numbers, man. These numbers. You know what I'm saying?
Capitol Theater, they told Trill and them, you know what I'm saying, that they're going to give them a real nice discount to have the Trill Awards down there.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, they only had to pay $200 to the Capitol. Is that what they said?
Man, listen. Honestly, man, the stuff that happened with them, I can't really recall, you know what I mean, exactly what happened. But I know one thing, like, whatever that's going on with the budget, man, the people that's down there is human, man. So mm-hmm. I can't really trust nobody, man. It don't matter how you dress, how you look, who your friends are.
Okay.
I mean, it's politics. So until we get in office to see how this works, and until we can get you in the spot and I can put you in the spot, we're going to always have this.
Yeah.
You know, we can keep talking about it, we can keep doing that, but until we get our spot,
right, exactly.
You know what I mean? The vote and all that, people keep saying vote and all that. There's some stuff you can do before you get in office that can change a lot of stuff. Expose these people. Everybody talk about the people that snitch on drug dealers, whatever they do.
Right.
Go ahead and get these people in the office, man, and talk about what they're doing.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? I want one day, I want to run for city council. You know what I'm saying? I'm an ex-felon. You know what I'm saying? I came home. I did what I needed to do. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't wish prison on my worst enemy, man. You know what I'm saying? That was some degrading-ass shit, man. And I ain't, you know what I mean? And like you say, we need more people in place like that. You know what I'm saying? And I feel everything you just said, bro. Shout out to Trill Magazine, man. They 20 years in the game, man. Come on, man. 20 years in the game, man. 20 years in the motherfucking game. Oh, yeah.
Well, see, listen, I'm 21, so that means I already started at once.
Right.
You took off 20 years.
No, honestly, man, I've been writing. I started writing poetry, man.
Okay.
Some of the first things I was writing was for my family at funerals, you know what I mean? So, you know, that's a tough job as a teenager, writing a funeral, go up there, you're losing your cousin, you know what I mean? And after that, man, I started writing for the Flint Journal, the Word Up section.
Okay, I remember that.
And, basically, they turned us into a journalism school, and we went from there. And I remember one of the first people. What was the Flint thing used to call? Was our summer jam? What was the thing?
I remember you talking about
the Super Show.
It was the Super Show. Shout out to the Super Show.
Yeah. So then that Montel Jordan, we did that, and the Flint Journal showed me how to do it. And then after that, I got a grant from Michael Moore. When Nike was supposed to bring the factory here, but didn't do it.
Okay.
I got a donation from Michael Moore. And then once I graduated, I was sitting with a bro, JTV. I remember like it was yesterday. We were sitting there, just graduated, sitting the wrong way on the street. We were sitting there smoking. He said, so what you going to do now?
Yeah.
I'm 17, man. I don't know. He said, start a magazine.
Where you go to school at? Where you go to college at?
I graduated from Mark. I got my degree from Mark. I got my other diploma from Hammony, but that was deep, man. Bro said start a magazine, and next day I read this book. I was waiting on my financial aid paperwork, and it said if you publish it, or if you print it, they will read it. And that was it. The next day I came up with the name.
How did you come up with that name, Trill?
I mean, at the time I was stuck on like the South, you know what I'm saying? But
UGK.
UGK too, but the meaning it really is like truth and reality. You know what I mean?
Right.
The truth is that we broke, but the reality is that we homeless.
Yeah. Y'all hear that? You know, I hear that straight from the man's mouth.
Truth and reality.
You know what I'm saying? Salute. Yeah, salute, man. Salute.
And so there we have it, you know. And then we went from there. We was doing like 10,000 copies and stuff, man. Numbers was up. Doing a lot of stuff in the prisons. And then after that, man, once we started going digital, the numbers went down. I was feeling actually bad until I saw the Flint Journal couldn't print. I was like, I ain't happy, but if they can't do it.
Exactly.
So bad.
Right. It wasn't okay. So bad.
If they can't, that's who taught the people who taught me.
Exactly. Wow. Yeah. Well, that's deep, man. That's a journey, brother. That's a journey, man. We all been on a journey. Everybody in here been on a journey, man.
You know what's beautiful?
You know what I'm saying?
Excuse my name.
Go ahead, Ocho GG. Go ahead.
What's beautiful about it is the tutelage and the apprenticeship that he went through. See, once again, it's about first things first. In order to learn anything, you must first display obedience. Obedience means you're listening. If you're talking when a teacher is teaching, you've already turned the teacher off to saying anything else to you. They're not ready to teach you until you come humbly with your ear open. All the game they gave you, you already knew that you were who you were and what your own identity was. But they gave you the skills for you to master the you that was always you. But first, you must be submissive to the teaching. And that becomes, again, when I go back to this chemical poisoning, that's one of the things that's accelerated by the pituitary gland not developing completely with us, because this now is moving so fast. I ain't got time to hear. It's not that and it almost hurts me because I worked in the juvenile field for 25 years, right? And it's crazy that I hear so many say, man, the kids messed up. No, the kids are a product of the person who birthed them into the world. And we all done been through this cycle over the last 50 years. So it ain't no one individual's to blame. It's like blaming the victim. It don't take no responsibility off your actions. But the issue is, what is the repercussion of being chemically poisoned? And what psyche evolves from that being? And then we done had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 generations with heroin epidemic in the 60s, and cocaine and crack and you know, ICE and every motherfucking thing else that we get every 10 years. And I was just going to say, and the number one poison that's been taken out on all families, especially low-income families, is the taking the male figure out of the family so that everything that resembles after the family is feminized.
And it's written in law.
Biblical, rather, and it don't matter, we ain't even going to waste no time with nobody or anybody's beliefs if you don't know something. You feel me?
Yeah.
The reality is, for me and you, for these brothers who sitting here to be standing here, and we said we're kings, well, we're saying we're kings because we represent the youth that's done already survived. We stand as a replica of you once you survive what you finna survive. Don't take, make sure, I want to make sure this is clear, that it's you we came to bring salvation to, man, and help to.
That's deep, cuz. That's H-O-G-G. Heavy on Glenn Goble. It just happened to be my family. You know what I'm saying? And it's knowledge. That's knowledge. Knowledge is the key. You know what I'm saying? The show is almost over. We're running low on time. Once again, I want to shout out my co-hosts today, my cousin Stoney C.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Stoney Carmichael on Facebook.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And my other cousin, H-O-G-G, Big Hall, Big Flint. Everybody knows Big Flint. Number one security in town. Y'all know who he is. Y'all don't. And same thing with Trill. Trill Mag. Shout out to Trill Mag. Y'all don't know who Trill Mag is. 20 years in the game, baby. 20 years in the game. Y'all don't know who they is. You're not from Flint. You're not from Flint. Everybody shout out. We finna sign off in a minute. You know what I'm saying? Anybody want to say anything?
Let me slide behind the camera.
Let me say
one thing. I used to read this down in Morgantown.
Lord have mercy.
That's the Fed lockup. That's the Fed lockup. Morgantown. You know what I'm saying? So good shout out.
That's the thing. We from the 810, the 0313. But that prison system, man, them boys still call, man. Get them out of there, man. MDOC.
Get them boys out of there, man. You know what I'm saying? I got a lot of brothers just down, man. I left a lot of brothers behind. Some good brothers. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Chanel. Shout out to Redbone. Chanel, man. We love you, man. Come home, man. Shout out to the homie Miko. Man, bring Miko home, man. Yo, bring that man home, man. Bring him home, man. Bring them home, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And if I forgot anybody, man, I love y'all. You know what I'm saying? This Flint After Dark, special edition from Your Place Family Room. You know what I'm saying?
Flint After Dark is not a fad.
Let me get it.
Flint After Dark is not just a fad.
It's going down.
This record label still slipping on us. I feel like white people still spitting on us, cause we can't drink the water still. So why we gotta pay the water bill if the government done quit it on us? Look, I love Obama, but it's fuck Obama. Fuck the whole United States, see I ain't trust Obama. He claimed the Flint to be a puppet, man I witnessed it. He lied and said the water was safe, when man sipped the shit. I swear to God, man I cried after that. And when you left, you know how many kids died after that? Stupid, I wonder if you still had your pride after that. Cause I burned every poster you ever had right after that. And look, motherfuckers wanna tell me that my vote count. If the person that we pick ain't in control, then it don't count. We need to stop trying to get these folks to accept us. Every 4 years, we just picking who we want to oppress us. So let me stop with the lecture, cause I guess I'm being extra. Cause I'm quick to raise the stock up like I'm an investor. These niggas say I'm being ignorant, no, I'm giving effort. And these bullets gon' start hitting shit like Conor McGregor. You ever wanted something from the stove, but you couldn't have it? You would've stole it, but it dropped because you couldn't grab it. Ski mask with the Glock, we wear two for a fashion. With one strapped over the shoulder like they do in the pageant. Hey, it's the school of hard knocks. I had too many classes, court dates and funerals. We got used to the habits. So when Gucci made that stupid ass sweater, I already seen more black faces on shirts than you can imagine. Either the shirt said free me or RIP me. These rap lyrics is watered down, this shit getting cheesy. Is it Kiki, is it Fifi, or was it ZZ? Is it Frankie, is it Stoney, or was it TT? Either way, I gotta set it off like Cleo did and set it off. For them days I had stress on my chest and I couldn't let it off. With my toy spray, Floyd May, this bitch ain't never lost. I put my life on the line and that's a line you should never cross. I'm from where they never make it, shit getting devastating. Your soul will start levitating, that's the only way you elevating. Cops will lay you down with a piece, but they ain't meditating. They was shooting for his chest, but since he black, it's melanated.